French fries, burgers, pizza, chicken, milkshakes, hot dogs, sandwiches, milkshakes, hot dogs, sandwiches.
We're here at Mike's Drive-In again in Milwaukee, Oregon.
Yeah, exact same menu as the other one, which I'm not mad about. It's a pretty good fucking menu.
Yeah.
Yeah, out in the middle of nowhere. Today is the first day of them reopening after our fucking shit storm, ice storm 2021 yeah. apocalypse. So it was a 40-minute wait, but that is our dedication to the craft.
That is correct.
Anywho, so we got entirely too much food again.
Entirely too much money, but
yeah, it was only $50. But the cool thing is, check that daddy out. A little fucking Mike's Drive-In mug. That's strong as death. Like that. So got a couple of big bad motherfucker things.
First off, chili fries.
Chili fries look all sorts of extra schmagged out, which I'm in. Then got Russ got his deep throat hot dog, chili dog. We've got a pastrami burger, which that's going to be pretty good. Is that a fucking chili dog in?
It is.
They gave it its own little box. What the fuck is that?
Yeah.
Holy shit. Look at that monstrosity.
Yeah, exactly.
You may need to. Oh, yeah. There you go. Look at that.
There's my hot chili dog with onions and tomato, which is kind of gross, but that's all right.
We got some fried.
Kind of hard to see the bun underneath there, but
some fried pickle action going on. Yeah. So these actually look pretty fucking similar to our Ringo's ones.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, since they are baskets, they give us two sets of fries. Two sets of cookies is what I was trying to get
that's
at.
That's correct.
And then I'm guessing this is my little pastrami action.
Yeah, pastrami burger.
Oh, fuck.
With Swiss.
Go ahead and show that to the people.
I'm trying not to dip it in the fries. So. Try to open it up so it's a little more visible.
Go for it.
Yeah, this is a pastrami burger.
So pastrami and Swiss on top of the regular deluxe burger.
Yes.
And then, here, let's hide the... Then they've got onion rings that we can just set aside for now until we get to them.
Okay.
One of the few things that I don't like about this place, your fucking onion rings and pickles and stuff do not come with any dipping sauces at all.
You gotta buy them separate,
which is a little stupid. But they're not expensive. 30 cents for one or two for 50 cent. We got the ranch. We got a little fry sauce action. You can't see because it's fucking dark outside.
Yeah.
But it's basically looks like probably mayonnaise and ketchup. Maybe there's some little Thousand Island type
orange,
shit going on.
Orangish color.
Did get a barbecue, and then we got a handful of ranches. So let's dig into this motherfucker, Goob.
All right. Let me start, since this is the first thing in my lap.
Yep, start on.
Start with the chili fries.
Chili fries that we got last time that were phenomenal.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and my little pastrami burger action gave you the option, and maybe it was because the chick was really into me. That could be it. Gave the option of grilled onions instead of just regular raw onions, which I'm a huge fan of.
She's obviously into the both of us because I managed to get her to take two different flavors of milkshake and combine them into one. So I've got a chocolate and milkshake, or a chocolate and marshmallow milkshake.
God damn!
Yeah, chocolate and marshmallow milkshake, which was awesome. Yeah, I'll get to that in a little bit.
Okay, this little pastrami burger is the shot. So I know he showed you earlier, but there's a good amount of pastrami on the top of that bitch.
Yeah.
That is fucking fantastic. And I'm not a pickle or tomato on a burger kind of a guy, but they're fantastic on here because it's a little dry, to be honest, outside of that. And then you get the little bit of saltiness from the pickle. That is fucking fantastic.
Yeah, I got the Reuben last time, and it is a little more sauerkraut.
That was a lot of sauerkraut.
Yeah, that I'm crazy about, but...
All right, Dick Smash.
I do like the flavor of pastrami.
Time to pass these back and forth so you can have a bite of this and give me that fork, Dick Face. There you go. Yeah, you're going to like that. I like that better than I like the motherfucker burger.
Mmm.
That's crazy good, isn't it?
That is delicious.
Yeah, that's as good as any burger I think I ever fucking had. Now, maybe the game changer is to get an egg onto that bitch.
Maybe.
Because the egg would make it, you know, a little less dry, too.
Dude,
they put more chili on this one than they did at the other place, too.
Maybe. Yeah, this one's really fucking good.
All right, let's move on to some other shit. You want your... Here, I'll take this.
Okay.
You can have your
hot dog.
No bite hot dog here. There you go. Grab
that. Yeah.
There you go.
This is going to probably require a fork at some point or another.
Oh, yeah.
We dug around
there was
enough
only
to
one.
Not find another fork, okay?
Well, we can't ask them to excel at their jobs.
Well, one more quick look. Yeah, you can't really see bun underneath there, but it's there. I see it. I'm going to have to cut away with
this. So you're saying they kind of look like your buns?
That was a really weak gay jab.
That wasn't even a gay jab. I was just saying that you shit your drawers all the time.
I'm
an equal opportunity
joke
maker.
99.9% likely that whatever joke you make, it's going to be gay-based.
Well, you work with the easiest material you got.
Wow. That.
So that, once again, the little fucking pickle action and some ranch.
The chili had a huge, chunks of beef in it. It's really fucking good.
Okay, these are way better than Ringo's. These are fucking great. They're not. Remember how the Ringo's one were kind of like soggy on the inside?
A little bit, yeah, yeah.
Those are not crisp at all.
Those are crisp.
Yeah, I mean, I wish we would. Clearly, they made these before we got the rest of the food.
Mm-hmm.
Because they're not fresh. But it's more solid, and they're still warm. Oh yeah, dude.
This is the stuff.
Mm-hmm.
This is good. Mm.
Okay.
Good chili.
That is supposed to come with mustard on it.
No, I
for disgusting trolls of human beings.
I did not want mustard on mine, so they did not put it on. Because I threatened to fucking samurai sword their head if they did.
Oh, that was a little fucking aggressive. We got fucking Toshiro Mifune here.
Yep. Oh, come on, damn it. Mmm.
So I think we got extra coating, and then you can see even there's dill in the breading. See?
Mm-hmm.
And I know that pickle isn't exactly what mashes with your fucking chili dog, but you got to grab one of these real quick.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, their chili is good.
Mm-hmm. Man, as soon as you finish that, you at least eat one of these cocksuckers.
Doesn't make it appetizing. Sorry.
What, you don't, your own can?
One? Good, not, no. Okay, yeah, definitely, some ranch on that puppy. Mmm.
See, this is a little more substantial.
Oh, definitely more crispy then.
And imagine if these were like fresh. These would be fucking perfect. That's they're way better than the Ringo's ones, huh?
Oh, definitely.
Yeah, that's really fucking good.
Mmm.
Yeah. So far, Mike's is absolutely fucking crushing it.
Yeah.
And there are actually two more things still that I know I would like to try. Well, three. There's a chili burger, which is going to be really fucking good since their burgers are good and their chili's good.
Yeah.
Shock and surprise. Let's do the math on that. Then there's also a jalapeno chipotle burger, which Russ isn't a jalapeno guy, but nope. I'm in. That sounds fucking killer. And then also a guacamole bacon, which I'm fucking in on that program too. But Goober does not.
They have, their beans are huge. And the portions of beef in the chili are huge.
Okay, so again, the bummer is that it seems it's not super, super fresh. But when they're doing 40 minutes out on an order, I'm going to give them a pass on it.
For sure. Yeah, they were busy.
But these are the more beer batter style, I would say. So they're not the frozen bullshit ones. These are real deal onion rings.
Yeah, let me state that Mike's is on the expensive side.
Well, okay, but yes and no.
Well, if you get the basket,
we had a $10 mug.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're on $40. Without the mug, we're at $40, and we got chili fries, we got pastrami burger, a chili dog, two shakes, a drink, a thing of pickles, thing of onion rings, and two cookies. When you really break it down like that, for $40, that's still a lot of food.
Yeah.
Just like it was $40 for three entrees last time. We just got one less dessert. I don't know how the fuck that works, but whatever.
Well, the big thing is if the sneaky expenses are when you get the baskets. And then you'll be like, oh, shit, they're expensive.
Because you get their bullshit garbage fries to start with. And then if you get anything else, it's either 75 cents or $1.50 to add on top of it.
You can do substitutions, but they'll certainly cost extra.
You. They whack you.
Mm-hmm. Baseball cap your knees, or a baseball bat your knees. Mm.
So the fry sauce is just Thousand Island, I think.
Yeah.
Or it's... It's more like a mayonnaise consistency.
It's more like an Arctic
what
Circle.
I'm guessing is it's ketchup, mayonnaise, and relish.
Mm-hmm. Typical.
Yeah, I mean, it's not bad.
Yeah, no, I think it always makes decent fry sauce. But if you want really good fry sauce, or at least try to do
an Arctic Circle.
a similar recipe to a Red Robin, where they used barbecue sauce. Barbecue sauce and mayonnaise. That was legitimate. Mm. Yeah, if you're
Fucking barbecue they got.
If you're a first timer coming to Mike's Drive-In, or Mike's Drive-In Virgin, or whatever you want to call it, definitely go for the chili. The chili is freaking tasty.
In whatever way, shape, form that you're doing, the chili is there.
Yeah,
you can buy it just as a bowl too.
Yeah, but yeah, definitely get the chili. And that pastrami burger was crazy.
Best thing they got so far, actually. And I love the chili everything's. I think the pastrami was the best thing. The pastrami burger was the best thing.
That's good stuff.
Decent barbecue sauce tastes like it's bullseye, most likely. At least it's not overpoweringly sweet, gross.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, I like the onion rings. But if you're in the Portland area, you're looking for onion rings, Boulevard Tap House. My buddy owns that fucking bar. Best onion rings on the fucking planet. They're out of control. Fuck, we ought to go over there and do one sometime.
That's Dwayne?
The Masso Brothers. Insurance guys, too. Oh.
Let me just...
One-stop shopping, get insurance and fucking onion rings.
Yeah. Let me just show, since I've been able to uncover the bun... There's the bun, and there's the
it does exist.
Hot dog next to it. Yeah.
All right.
But this is really good stuff.
Well, let's... You ought to try an onion ring when you're done with that. And then we got to skip to dessert, so we don't sit here and talk to people for 20 minutes.
Pick on this a little bit later.
If you got room at your feet, grab an onion ring. I'm sure you want
ranch. Kind of on the soggy side.
Yeah, but that's, you can tell it's because they've been sitting.
Yeah, they, oh yeah, they've, yeah.
Dude, this pastrami burger's fucking stupid.
Dip this sucker in the ranch. Mmm. You really, I don't know if I've ever had bad onion rings.
I think the Jack in the Box onion rings are bad.
I don't think I've ever had theirs. I think their tacos are bad.
Well, see, the trick on the tacos, as disgusting as it sounds, you get it with no lettuce and add ranch into it, and they're fucking stellar.
Oh, ranch! Ranch makes just about everything.
God damn. Which is weird because he's like this guy that was ate nothing but fast food and drank Mountain Dew and shit and was like 102 pounds forever, and how he hasn't had a heart attack, couldn't tell you.
You have to have active bowels. That's my secret. I should probably weigh 300 pounds, but...
Well, you walk like 9 miles a day at work, too.
True. And if you can induce a tapeworm into your body, that probably will help.
What a good thing that would be. Maybe we can start that as a business. Tapeworm therapy?
Get America to jump in on a new diet plan.
Holy fuck. Okay, so let's figure out our little dessert action here. All right, so, Goober, tell the people what you got. Look at that, fucking 32-ounce milkshake. Jesus.
Big. And it is chocolate and marshmallow. And, yeah, you might have to ask the staff to merge two different flavors for you, but they'll do it.
They will.
Because they're taking a lot of money from you already, so they really should.
And Russ is the expert when he talks about big when he's jamming it into his mouth.
He's getting his freaking stupid.
Well, hey, in this 17 minutes that we've been fucking rocking and rolling, that's how cold and well they do their milkshakes. This thing you can still barely move the straw in.
Yeah, it's these are good shakes. Got a lot of different flavors, too.
Okay, so the chocolate peanut butter is legit. Yeah, that's pretty fun. Good. It really, and it sounds pretty stupid, but it really tastes like you're drinking a Reese's peanut butter cup.
Mm-hmm.
So they've done it. It's not like overpoweringly sweet, which is good. It's not like, and that's where like, you know, some chocolate is like super fucking sweet. It's not overpowering that way, or that would fuck up the milkshake. We gotta do a little trade-a-roo too, so we can.
Yeah, you can definitely taste. It's a good solid chocolate, and you can taste the hint of marshmallow in there at the little gooey.
Yours is fucking legit.
Mm-hmm.
Yours is better than the peanut butter one. Peanut butter one's good.
That is good.
I still like this a little bit better, and I like the first place in fucking Idaho we went to. I thought theirs was a little bit better.
Culver's,
probably. Yeah. A little bit better than this on the peanut butter chocolate shake, but not by a lot. This is legit.
I really like the the peanut butter.
Oh, the peanut really butter hits itself. Yeah, because you can get regular just peanut butter with the vanilla. That might even be even better. But anyway, that's pretty fucking good.
Mm-hmm.
So what is your thoughts, Goob, here all together now that we had two runs at Mike's, the best of the best? What do you like best?
The chili flat out. Is
really good chili.
Unbelievable. But your pastrami burger was very, very good. Pastrami was Swiss.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I agree. I think the pastrami burger was the best of the entrees. If at some point we pop in and do a chili burger, I bet you the chili burger is fucking legit. But it's going to be tough to beat the pastrami burger. That was fucking
That's good. Very good. Yeah.
Again, the chili fries are stellar. I thought the pickles were really good.
Mm-hmm.
Better than Ringo's. Those seashore fries or whatever the fuck they called, those were pretty good. Regular fries, the shoestring fries that weren't crispy at all, were really underwhelming. Onion rings, I would like to see what they're like fresh. But I'm not a huge onion ring guy to begin with. But yeah, Mike's is fucking legit. It is not cheap, but you do get a good amount of food. Really, I think the value is okay. It is just it's a burger basket that costs $12, and then you add on an additional $1.50 to get
any
good
additional
side.
Things or whatever. Yeah,
is a hair pricey. So I don't know. It's really fucking good though, and it's kind of cool. I don't know if you saw in the little video earlier, but there's a whole outdoor seating area and shit too. So it's I don't know. I like the spot. This one here in Milwaukee seems like it's a little more spacious. There's a little tiny lot on the Oregon City one.
Yeah, and if you weren't deaf before
Holy
you got air,
shit.
The friggin' PA is...
Scared the goddamn life out of me.
The decibels are off the chart.
Yeah, it's pointed right at you unsuspectingly while you're standing in the line. Fucking 237, it's ready! Jesus!
Yeah, you will empty your bowels onto the ground.
We did.
Jesus.
So anyway, and then the quick question above it all. Of all of our stops so far, what are your rankings? Call it your top three. You got to discard the others of the burger places, right?
Oh.
So we got Mike's. We're going to combine the Mike's to one because it's the same thing at both locations.
Mike's. And Culver's.
Culver's
and Freddy's Steakhouse or whatever it was.
And then we had Roke's, and then we had Ringo's. Roke's. So what do you think? How did you line those up? I'm actually picking this above Roke's, which is surprising because I really like Roke's. But that pastrami burger, fucking put it over the top.
That's too difficult for me to do because there's just certain things about each. There's certain things about each place that just kind of jumped out and was better than others. I can't really generalize.
Oh, quit being a bitch. So I will say our three Portland spots were better than both of the Boise spots. Though I will say there were things about the Boise ones that were really good, like that peanut butter chocolate shake was fucking silly. And the second place had really good chili fries, too. Totally different than this style, but they were really good, too.
Yeah.
And we got to see the Smurf Turf while we were out there, which was pretty cool.
Oh, yeah.
And you made out with a dinosaur.
Boise State Field, we got to take pictures of that. And you didn't have to fucking wear a mask to go in, which was...
Right? Yeah. Nobody got yelled at for no mask here. That's good.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. But anyway, I guess that's probably about it for now. Until next time, this would be Coach Shiley and Glory Hole Goober.
No, I don't know where that stupid shit came up. Crazyclimber80.
Stop, Russell.
Idiotic.
I'm not denying that. Anyway, signing off, and we'll see you guys next time around for more cool adventures and more bad jokes.
Peace out, folks.
See ya.
Bye. French fries.